Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We meet today in another episode of the manners of our behavior, or the behavior of our manners. And our example today is we were having our iftari in Istanbul in a restaurant last year. And the waiter gave us 3 dates for each one of us. And I thought this is not enough. And I was asking my young colleague to go to the flat, which was not far away from the restaurant, to get more, because there were plenty of dates at home. And I said, please don't embarrass the restaurant owner, because this is like an insult for them, telling them that the food is not enough. And the argument between me and him went on and on and on till he convinced me. So I listened to him. Okay. Then while we are doing this kind of argument, a young Syrian, looked like a Syrian refugees, very well built, and they came and he was begging for food or for money to sit down. And the waiter came rushing to try to throw him out of the restaurant. I was sitting looking at the scene without doing anything, because I was distracted by the beautiful dishes on the table and the hunger in my stomach. And I did not realize how painful to the young man to start begging at that time. And I was only looking at him as a young, strong, and able, without actually looking deeply at his psychological or social status. At that time, my desire to eat because of the hunger was more stronger than desire to help such young man. And I remember the incident which happened to Imam Ali alayhi salam and Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam, when 3 consecutive nights the miskeen and orphan and a prisoner of war came out to ask for their food, their iftari food, where they have nothing at home apart from this piece of bread. But they decided to give to them the food and carry on fasting without eating. In our condition, it was different. We have plenty of food, we have more resources, but Hazrat Ali alayhi salam and Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam did not have the resources to buy for them or for themselves. And this, for 3 consecutive nights, they actually were actually fasting without food. In this condition of this young Syrian man, it was a practical application of the true feeling of how the miskin feels, and don't be deceived by the body build of such people or the way they dressed, because begging is humiliation, is badly humiliating the individual, losing his credibility and his integrity. It's more painful than breaking the bones of the young man or cutting the stomach and the flesh of such young man. And this is another lesson to somebody like me, who is claiming that he is a humanitarian worker and who is claiming that he is standing up for the need of the poor people. When it comes to a lesson like this, he did not react swiftly to stand next to the young man. You know what happened to the young man when the waiter was trying to throw him out? The people on the next table said, no, don't touch him. Bring him a chair and bring him a dish and we'll feed him. We should have deserved to do that, because we are the people who claim that we are the people champion, not actually anybody else. So my apology for the young Syrian man who was not fed on our table, and my apologies to you. And what I am saying is, this could be considered the black hypocrisy in the heart of individuals like myself or not. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.